Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another American Truck Simulator video. My name is Moose78. Hopefully you guys are having a good day today. And today we are finally back with Stories from the Road. I know I've been kind of hit and miss on the uploads here lately, but definitely want to get back into it this week. And we're going to do something a little bit different, kind of here and there, kind of moving forward. As I've been talking over the last few weeks, I've been saying that I've, you know, wanted to get into some live streaming, and I have been doing that a couple times recently over on Twitch TV, and that's what we're going to be taking a look at today is some highlights from some trips that I made over on my live stream this past Friday, March 3rd. But in reality, it's not really going to be any different than the Stories from the Road that I've been doing in the past. It's just kind of a live version of it, more or less, interacting with people, talking about some things, just having some conversations, asking questions, things like that. So hopefully you guys will enjoy it. And plus, I kind of want to share the live streams with those that are not able to watch them, because I kind of do them at kind of a weird time, I guess. I usually start around 10 a.m. Eastern time and usually go about 2 or 3 hours. But this first trip here, I'm using the Kenworth T680. We are on the 1.6 open beta, and that's why I wanted to break the 680 back out, is just to check out some of the new things, some of the new sounds they've updated, some of the new features they've implemented. But don't worry, the normal Stories from the Road will also still be getting uploaded a couple times a week as well. Got some stuff, other stuff that I want to do later on this week. Want to do a review of the updated Mac Pinnacle. Want to get the W900A model that some of you guys might have seen me use on stream about a week or so ago. I want to get some footage up of that on the channel. But yeah, that's kind of what I got going on right now, so hopefully you guys enjoy it. We're going to cut on over to the trip. We're running from Yuma up to Barstow with a reefer from the utility trailer pack there on the Steam Workshop. So hopefully you guys enjoy it. If so, just give it a like and a share. This helps me out a bunch and helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please take a look around, watch a couple videos, and consider subscribing now. But guys, we're going to cut on over to the gameplay, and we'll catch you in the next video. Hey, what's going on, Deluminator? How you doing today? Hotel's just right over here. Now this could be a little bit interesting getting out, but I think it should not be too much of a problem. Go. Let's see. So I don't think I can drive around this. I seen that. I was pretty excited about that too. It's just for World of Trucks. That's okay though. We can still dream, right? Let's go back up to that little, over there, and should be able to get out. sidewalk there. Now, it's going to be a little bit tight getting out, but we will manage for sure, for sure. I don't know why I keep doing that. Now, luckily, there shouldn't be any traffic coming this way, so kind of block the road just a little bit for a second. Eh, not too bad. Too bad at all. So what do you guys think of the beta so far? Like a lot of the little new features? I do like the little way station thing in the window. I think that's pretty cool. Little details like that, I think, for me at least personally, really set a mod off, or really, you know, set a truck off. Just kind of give it that nice little touch. And even with the sound fixes pack that I have active from the Steam Workshop, I can still notice a lot of the new engine sounds and truck sounds and stuff like that that SCS has put in the game. So that's pretty cool. I definitely think you're gonna see trailers with liftable axles sooner than later. In fact, I've already seen at least one mod out that does that. Yeah, some pretty small changes overall, but yeah, I think you're definitely spot on there. They do add up. See if that keeps. If I keep getting lag spikes like that, I'm gonna have to hop out just real quick and turn the overclock off on my GPU. And hopefully new states aren't too far behind. Start running over into New Mexico. I guess still a 25 through here, so better slow down just a bit. So I'm good on fuel, so I'm not gonna worry about stopping. But actually, yeah, let's go ahead and do stop. Let's go ahead and do stop, just because, in case there's someone out there that hasn't seen or heard of anything with the 1.6 beta here for ATS. So you used to, you only had one fuel pump that you could pull up to. But what's this black magic? Oh, multiple fueling points now, which is pretty awesome. Which is nice, because it's going to make it really nice when you pull into little fuel stations like this, so you're not rubbing up against that sign, or it's going to make it a little less challenging to get in here and get some fuel. Say after the last stream, and I about ran out of fuel a couple times, figured better safe than sorry. Better safe than sorry. Can't quite see what's coming that way. Not nothing. The two-piece light bar that I added on. Oops. That's one thing that I've always, even back, you know, when I was modding hauling, always one of the things that I put on my trucks is a two-piece light bar. I don't think they look good on all trucks, but when a truck, you know, is done just right, I think they look pretty good. Oh, gosh dang it. I'll see how it runs once we get going here. I glanced over at that 579 coming up the ramp there, and I thought at first glance it was a Volvo. I was like, what? What? Not just the old 579. We start to see some more updates a little bit more frequent now too. That'd be kind of nice. Like maybe here in the next month or so we'll get New Mexico. You know, maybe we can, you know, get some monthly updates. Must have snuck back into California. Speed limit went down to 55. Set right there, 57, and be good to go. Well, they've added to their team quite a bit over the last year too, right? Like they said, when they started out, they had like 8 employees working on ATS. And now they have a little over 20 working on each ATS and Euro Truck Sim too. So I mean, more than, you know, double the size of your company in just over a year is pretty awesome. I mean, they almost, you know, triple the size of the company. So that's pretty awesome. There and keep on going. Holy cow, yeah, that'd be pretty awesome. For a small company like SES, I think they've really made some big strides, you know, in the last year. Not just with, you know, ATS, but also Euro Truck Sim too. And if you guys are seeing lag like that, that's in game. That's, you know, nothing to do with the stream or anything. So, apologize for that. But I mean, just recently they had a DLC for Euro Truck Sim 2 that was a, you know, an official Goodyear tire pack. And of course there's been mods like that out in the community for a while. But to see them able to officially release something like that and kind of grow a partnership with a huge brand like Goodyear is pretty awesome. You know, and obviously they've established a relationship with PACCAR, the makers of the Kenworth and the Peterbilt, as well as some European truck companies. And so that's good. That's, you know, a very, very good starting point for them. You know, it's kind of cool to see the actual, you know, models in-game with the actual names, you know, Kenworth, Peterbilt, so on and so forth, instead of, you know, like back in the day, the Pacifico or, you know, whatever some of the cheesy names were that they came up with. And they couldn't quite get the models 100% accurate because, you know, they could, you know, potentially get sued or something like that. It might have been Michelin. I know it was a major tire brand. I think you're right, though. I think it was Michelin. So what are we coming up on here? Zoom out just a bit. To the left in the second junction. Slow down just a skosh. Crash over there. Is that what it was, the bus crash? Or did I miss it? Hey, what's going on, Bengata? Thanks for stopping by and hanging out. How you doing today? Trucking up to Barstow right now. Oh, okay. I like how they put little stuff like that in there. It's kind of neat. There. What is new with 1.6? Liftable trailer axles is a thing now. I'm not sure if any of these stock SES trailers have them yet, but I know there's people working on some mods to be able to use that feature. So definitely be on the lookout for some new trailer mods coming out. It's definitely be a lot more heavy haul stuff, I bet. Which will be cool. Yeah, if you notice, notice that little blue thing there in the middle of the windshield. That's something new. So when you go past like a way station sign now, it's gonna beep and it's gonna either give you the red sign or the green sign. The and they have adaptive transmissions now to where you can set it to like standard, eco. And there was like one other setting, I can't remember what it is offhand, but on this particular truck, I'm using a modded transmission off the workshop, so it probably does not apply to this yet. Oh, actually, I got the green light on it yesterday. Was messing around a little bit last night with the update. Oh, now I don't know what they're gonna use it for, at least not yet, or what they have planned for it, but we also have differential locks in game now. So that could be interesting to see what they do with that. Then they just tweaked some sounds in game. Tweaked that air brake or air pressure simulation. So it's a little bit more realistic. You know, now you can hear the tire sounds a little bit more over loud engines. So not a huge update, but some nice little things that I think are going to go a long way. And if you mod the game at all, they updated the SES Blender tools yesterday as well, so. And if you use a Zmodeler 3, I know Oleg put out a beta update yesterday as well, because apparently it changed the PMG's files. So, I downloaded Blender yesterday and got all the SES tools and all that stuff. I think I'm going to give Blender a shot. Sounds like there's a little bit of a learning curve to it. It's a little bit different than Zmod, but definitely has its benefits. Yes, I am using, let me get around the curve here. I'm using a modded version of a Kenworth T680 that I did here recently. That I've been kind of working on. Once we get to a good stopping point, I'll kind of stop and take a little bit better look at it, but got a few videos of it over on my YouTube channel as well. Like the W9s or the Peterbilts too, but you know, in game I like to use, you know, be a little bit different and kind of use some of the aero trucks, you know, try to make them look cool, which I think Kenworth came out with this variant of the T680 last spring. And at first glance I was like, man, that's kind of, yeah, I don't know about that, but it kind of grew on me and I definitely like it. You know, because it's still an aero truck, but it kind of has, you know, without the skirts and all that stuff, still kind of has that classic, you know, look to it, if you will, with just the steps and the fuel tanks and, you know, none of the aero skirts and all that stuff. It's got the side-mounted stacks, of course, and but I definitely like on the newer trucks how the dash is laid out, you know, the steering wheel, all that stuff, all the bells and whistles. Typically, when I'm using like the W900 or the 389, I'll go with one of the SEI wheels. heavy are we here? Decent, 40,000 pounds. Then the trailer I'm using is one of the utility trailers from the utility trailer pack out on the Steam Workshop. And I'm really glad the workshop is as popular as it is. It's just nice and convenient. Thank you. You know, if there's any updates to a mod, you know, it'll automatically, if you have it set to, it'll automatically update to the latest version of that mod, so you're not constantly having to go out and, you know, check the internet for, you know, the latest update to a mod or something like that. If you go over to my YouTube page and check out any of my videos, any of my latest videos, in the video description I got a list of all the mods that I'm using in game. Ticket number one. Ah, he was behind me, okay. Any mods that I recommend? There's definitely a lot of good ones out there. If you're using like the W900, Alan Polly has a good mod out on the Steam Workshop. W900 add-on pack adds, he's updated that quite a bit and he continues to update it. And I actually want to try to send him some stuff from my modded W900 that he can implement with his mod out there on the workshop. But it adds a lot of stuff, you know, new fuel tanks, new side steps, new exhaust, lots of cool stuff. So that would be one I would definitely check out. The truck mods, I don't use a lot of truck mods, really. I have the Viper 389 installed, but I really never use it. You know, one of these days I want to sit down and get my own version of a 389 in-game from an old Holland mod. Just haven't got around to doing that yet. But that's, you know, the Viper 389, that's a pretty popular one. A lot of people use that. The utility trailer pack is definitely one I'd recommend if you like pulling reefer trailers. But definitely hop on the Steam Workshop and just, you know, check out some stuff, because there's a lot of good quality stuff out there for sure. A lot of good sound mods, like Creech Bomb, he does an amazing job with sound mods. Like right now I'm using his Mega Pack 2.4. And the engine that is in the T680 here is the N14 Select Plus. It's like the 600 or 610 horsepower version of that. Thing sounds awesome. And his sound mods are pretty spot on too. Thing I definitely like about the newer aero trucks are the side mirrors. Nice, big, and wide. Spot mirrors are nice and big. see, we should be coming up on... That is right over there. So another mod to check out that I got from the Steam Workshop is the longer yellow light mod. It's really nice. You know, does just what it says, makes the yellow lights just a little bit longer so you don't have to worry about getting, you know, running the red light ticket or whatever there. Oh yeah, there is no way I'm even gonna attempt to back this big old thing up to that dock. At least not right now. So, go ahead, hand deliver this guy, sorry, I'm in a hurry. Alright guys, well that's going to wrap it up for another American Truck Simulator video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. And if you guys liked kind of what you saw on the stream there, be sure to check out my twitch.tv channel. Link for that is in the video description. Going to try to stream a couple days a week, maybe on like on a Wednesday, Friday, might even throw a Monday in there every once in a while. I usually start around 10 a.m. So be sure to come over, check it out, hang out. But if you liked today's video, just give it a like and a share. It helps me out a bunch. It helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please take a look around, watch a couple of videos, and consider subscribing now. Guys, I'm going to cut on out of here for now. Till the next video, stay safe out there, take care, and we'll be seeing you.